to MooMooMath. Today we are going to look at how to find the volume of composite figures. Okay, all we're doing here is taking the volume of three-dimensional shapes and adding them together to find the volume of the whole thing. So let's look at what we have here. Okay, first we have a pyramid on top of a rectangular prism. So let's do the easy one first. Let's do the rectangular prism, or the bottom, this base part. Okay, the rectangular formula for a prism is base area times a height. So let's kind of identify our base here. Okay, our base is this shape right here, which is 6 by 5. It's a rectangle, so it's just going to be 6 times 5, or 30. And then we're going to multiply it by the height of that little pyramid. Well, the height over here is 3. It's 3 all the way around. So multiply that by 3. So that gives us 90. 90 feet cubed would be the volume of our prism. Now let's look at the pyramid on top. Okay, the pyramid, to find its volume, it's basically the same thing. We're going to take 1/3, though, of the base area times the height. So pyramids and cones, you always take 1/3 of the volume of the related prism. Okay, so let's look at our pyramid. This is our base with a side of 5 and 6. So this is 6 and this is 5. So it's got the same base area as the rectangle we just worked with. So that's 30. So the base area of our pyramid is 30 times the height. Well, that's given to us. It's the altitude straight in the middle. So that gives us 30 times 7, which is 210. Now 210 times 1/3, which is also the same thing as dividing by 3, that just gives us 70. So the volume of our pyramid over here is 70 cubic feet. Now, since they're a composite figure, we're going to take both of these and just add them together to get the volume of the entire figure. So that's 160 cubic feet. And that is how you'd find the volume. Okay, let's look at one that involves cylinders and spheres. So this one's a little bit different. A cylinder has a volume that is the base area times the height. Okay, but on a cylinder, the base is a circle. So let's think, what's the area of a circle? Pi r squared. Let's take that times the height. Now you may need to take your paper and turn it and look at it like this so you can see your base is a circle and this is your height. Okay, ignore the sphere for a minute, or that's a hemisphere actually. And let's concentrate just on this circle. Okay, the circle has a radius of 3, so let's take 3 squared, which is 9 pi. That's my base area. And then what's the height of this? Well, again, if you need to turn it, you can see, well, my height is 7. So that's my 7. And that gives us, 63 pi. And that gives us the volume of the cylinder, and that would be in miles cubed because it's three-dimensional. Now let's go over here and talk about the sphere for a minute. This is a hemisphere, just half a sphere. So we want to take 1/2 of the volume of a sphere, where the sphere formula is 4/3 pi r cubed. So let's simplify this part first. 1/2 of 4/3 would be 4 2/3. So we're going to take 2/3 times pi r cubed. Well, our radius is the same as the radius of the base of this circle. So let's plug in 3 and cube it. Okay, 3 cubed is 27, and we have to multiply that by 2/3. So let's take our calculators, take 27 times 2, that's 54, divided by 3, 18. So this simplifies to 18 pi, and that is the volume of this hemisphere. Now, it's a composite figure, so we're just going to add these together. So 18 pi plus 63 is, I multiplied, 18 plus 63 is 81. So the volume of 63 pi plus 18 pi is 81 pi. And let's add our units, miles, and its volume, so it's cubed. And that is how you find the volume of this composite figure with a cylinder and a hemisphere. Hope this was helpful.